Hello and welcome to the first part of my LEGO Mindstorms EV3 programming tutorial for the LEGO Mindstorms Scratch software. And you probably don't know the software because originally the LEGO Mindstorms EV3 was programmed with the LabVIEW software, which looked a bit different. But now there's a new software that works on modern systems, including Mac and Android devices. This tutorial is for this software. And it's actually a tutorial for three systems. It's for the EV3, for the LEGO Mindstorms Robot Inventor, and for Spike Prime, because their programming environment and their programming style is pretty much the same. So this part is for the LEGO Mindstorms EV3, and you can check the playlist in the description for these parts or for the correct parts for your Mindstorms. For some parts, it will split up, because some software solutions don't have some features that other software solutions have and stuff like that. This is the first part for the LEGO Mindstorms EV3 for both the retail version and the education version. And first you have to get the software, and that's pretty simple. For the education version, you can get it on the LEGO Education website. I will link it in the description. Until you can select your operating system, macOS, Windows 10, Chromebook, Android or iPad, and you can either download the app in the App Store or download the installer, at least for systems where you can use an installer. And for the retail version, you can go to the LEGO Mindstorms website, and here you can select your device, but you can't download a standalone installer, you can only install the app in the App Store. That looks pretty much like this, depending on your operating system. In my case, it's Windows 10, so I can download the apps in the App Store. And I've downloaded both of them, the LEGO Mindstorms Education EV3 Classroom software and the LEGO Mindstorms Home Edition. And the softwares are pretty much the same. So we have the education version with the education models and the education projects. It has a getting started option, and it has these units with models. Here you can build the robot trainer, or to be more precise, you can check the building instructions in the build tab, and here you can build the drive base up to the color sensor down. Because we need all of them, we need the driving base, we need the ultrasonic sensor for the education model, and we need the color sensor. And it's similar with the Home Edition, because here you can build tracker, you can go to the models, go to tracker, and here you can build tracker 01 and all of the tracker models up until tracker 05. I think that you can also build tracker 01 and tracker 05 without the other ones, but that's up to you. If you've built the model, you will have this one. I don't have the education model at hand, but this is the model. And both models, the education model and the model for the retail version, should have the same, let's say, layout. Both have two motors to drive, one per side. So we don't have one motor for driving and one for steering, but we have one motor for the left side and one motor for the right side. You can use tracks, you can use wheels, you can build your own robot, you can use the ones that I mentioned. You just have to have one motor on the left side and one motor on the right side to follow this tutorial. And in addition to that, you need one motor with an extra task. In this case, it can spin this propeller. And you need the ultrasonic or the infrared sensor, depending on your model. So you need the ultrasonic sensor in the education version and the infrared sensor in the Home Edition, and it should point forwards or backwards. And last but not least, we need the color sensor, and that should point down so that you can see the color of the bottom or of the floor. And that's the software. Oh, and another important thing to note, this tutorial works best if you ask me your questions. So I will make a tutorial in general, but I will try to cover your questions as well. So You can try to program stuff on your own, but if you're stuck, you can ask me for help, and then I might make a part for this tutorial because other people might learn from your questions as well. So it helps both of us if you ask questions. You can find solutions for your problems, and I can make an interesting tutorial. But now let's get to the layout of the software. It's similar for both of the software solutions. We have this gear on the top right corner, and here we can go to the help category. Here you can find explanations for all of the blocks and all of the options and stuff like that. So you can read there if you don't know something and if you want to get an explanation for it. But it's hidden and it's not very good to read because there are no images, but it's better than nothing nonetheless. And then we can create a new project. And this is the programming environment. We have a start block where we can add blocks, and that will be executed one after another. So here we can make playlists, or we can write our program step by step, and then the robot will do the program or execute the program step by step. And to download the program to the robot, we will have to connect it to the computer. And this is possible with this connect button. But let me go to the retail version. Let me create a new project. And here we can click on connect. And now I already enabled Bluetooth on my EV3. You can do that in the settings tab. So you can go to the right until you're in this tab. And here you can go to Bluetooth and enable it. You can also enable iPhone, iPad, iPod if you have a device like that. But in my case, it's Windows, so I don't have to enable iPhone, iPad, or iPod. And you can also connect it via USB. You can press here to connect it via USB or via Bluetooth. I don't think that it's possible to connect the EV3 via Wi-Fi, and the software has some other limitations, but we might get to that in the future. It works with the main hardware, so and we will mostly use that in this tutorial. But now we can connect to the EV3, and it's already connected. And now we get the sensor values, so we can see the rotation values for the motors and the distance of the infrared sensor and the color or the reflected light intensity for the color sensor. And it's very useful for debugging. Some programs might not work until you can try to find out why it doesn't work. So it's always wise to keep an eye on the sensor values. And now we can write our program and test it. Here we can download the program, or we can execute it. And maybe a note, here we have different categories. We can control single motors, we can control pairs of motors for movement. That's for motors, one on the left and one for the right, like the models are. We can control the display, the sound, and other complicated stuff that we will talk about in the future. Also, here we can select that we want to see fewer coding blocks or more coding blocks, depending on what you want. But that was it for the first part of this tutorial. You can try to come up with your own programs, or you can try to discover the software on your own until the next part is released. Thanks for watching. Also, keep in mind to tell me your questions, or to tell me where you've had problems programming, or just give me ideas for topics for the videos if you have some things that you're interested in, or if you have any questions or stuff like that. So thanks for watching the first part. Make sure to check the playlist for your robot, so either the EV3 playlist or the playlist for Spark Prime or the playlist for Robot Inventor. See you in the next video, and bye!